What do Serena Williams, Danica Patrick, Lindsey Vonn, Ronda Rousey, and Maria Sharapova all have in common? They're all badass women, not on the list of the 100 highest paid athletes in the world. In fact, not a single woman is on that list. Not one. Instead, the men on this new list out this week made a record $3.8 billion. That is up 23% from the previous year. To be fair, one of the reasons cited, team sports are exploding thanks to TV deals. But when you look at the individual level, I want you to look at these comparisons. Roger Federer, $77 million to Serena Williams, $18 million. Lewis Hamilton, $51 million. Danica Patrick, $10.3 million. Just keep this in mind. The women's soccer team filed a lawsuit a couple of years ago arguing discrimination over their salaries since their team actually brings in more than the men's team. But perhaps more importantly in this whole conversation, the people who don't make the millions, who are not standing out there on red carpets or on the Forbes list. When asked about the pay disparity just in Hollywood, actress Amy Adams says this. Let me quote her. I want to fight for people outside our industry. Let's start with our teachers. Let's get waiters paid the same minimum wage. That's what's great about what's happening with Time's Up. We're starting to have bigger conversations than just about what's happening in Hollywood. And let me just end with this. You know, talking about what we make still seems so taboo. I did something recently I had never done before, something that actually felt a little uncomfortable for me at first. I told a girlfriend, a colleague, how much I make. I told her so that when time comes for her to negotiate her salary with her boss, that she is armed with not just numbers, but knowledge. We need to start speaking up about this. We need to stand up for what we're worth.